हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट यूनिवर्स. फर्स्टली आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू सम क्वेश्चन. वेयर डू वी लीव? वी लीव ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ. एंड व्हेन वी लुक एट द स्काई, हाउ द स्काई लुक्स लाइक? इट लुक्स क्लियर. व्हेन इट इज़ नॉट क्लाउडी, इट लुक्स वेरी क्लियर. येस, एंड एट द नाइट टाइम हाउ द स्काई लुक्स लाइक? It looks like dark because sun is not there, and due to the sun rays during the daytime, the sky appears clear, and at night it appears dark, and we can see some stars twinkling around and the moon over there. So the sky is a part of the atmosphere, and we can see the sky from the surface of the Earth. So today we are going to discuss about the universe, and in the universe, in this chapter, we are going to discuss about the solar system, that is the planets. There are 8 planets in the solar system. We are going to discuss about that, and also about the comets and the asteroids. So firstly, what is universe? So universe is a vast space that contains everything that exists. The universe contains the stars, the planets, the satellite, the gases and the dust. Everything you can see in the universe. So what are galaxies? Galaxies are nothing but the cluster of several billions of stars. They are mixed together with the gases and the dust. They are mixed with their together with the gases and the dust. They are separated from each other by millions of kilometers, and they are held by the gravitational force. What do you mean by gravitational force? That some force is there that binds them together. And they move from one place to another. They always move away from each other. So we can see few galaxies with the help of the naked eye, but many of them we can't see. We require a very powerful telescope to see it. Yes, so telescope, if you see the galaxies, it is very wonderful. We reside on a home planet. What is the home planet name? Yes, it is the Earth. So we reside on the Earth, and it is a part of the solar system. So solar system, what is solar system? It is a part of the solar system. Solar system is a family of the star with its 8 planet, and some satellites are also there. The satellites revolve around the planet. So the Earth resides on one corner of the galaxies, and this galaxy is called the Milky Way. So now about the solar system. Solar system is any star orbited by planet. Here the star is the sun. Here the star is the sun. Our solar system is our sun orbited by the 8 planet, and they constitute a family. And what are the 8 planet? It is Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. So these are arranged according to the distance away from the sun. So the planet is a body that does not produce its own light. What are the planet? Planet are body that doesn't produce their own light and take the light of the sun, and they revolve around the main star, that is the sun. And what is the moon? Moon is a natural satellite. Earth satellite is moon, and moon is a natural satellite that revolves around the planet. So like Earth has its own satellite moon, so other planet also have their own satellite. Jupiter has around 28 satellites. Uranus has around 15 satellites, and Neptune has around 8 satellites. So now we are going to learn about the different planets, starting from the Mercury, which is very close to the sun. In the picture we can see the planets that revolve around the sun. Mercury is the very closest planet to the sun, and it is the smallest one. Mercury was named by the Romans after the fleet-footed god, because it revolves around the sun very fast. It is the fastest planet, and it revolves around the sun very fast. It is the smallest planet, and it is very nearest to the sun. It is around 40 40% diameter less than that of Earth and 40% diameter more than that of our moon. It is also the smallest planet in the solar system. Now coming to Venus. Venus is the second planet in the solar system. It is the hottest planet of all in the solar system. It is hot because the sun rays are going to the Venus, the planet Venus. But while radiating out, it doesn't come out though, because the atmosphere of Venus is very dense. So it traps the solar energy and makes the planet very hot. So the sky generally appears orange, also called the goddess of love and beauty, and also it is called the jewel of the sky by the Romans. It is also called the morning and the evening star. It is very near to the Earth and it is also the same size of that of the Earth. Yes, it is also called the sister planet to the Earth. So Venus is nearby to Earth. And it is the hottest planet. Now coming to Earth, where we live, our home planet. Earth is the third planet in the solar system. It constitutes of around 70% of water. So it is called a blue planet. And 30% constitutes the land. Also, the atmosphere of Earth has around 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen and 1% of other gases. So it makes the Earth a planet for the living organism to survive. No other planet is as such like it. Also, the spinning of the Earth around itself and the nickel chromium layer that it has makes the gravitational force very strong. Also, the atmosphere is so maintained so that it radiates the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun, that is the ozone layer. The ozone layer helps us to absorb the ultraviolet rays of the sun, making it a very good planet for us to survive, and the life is there on Earth. Now coming to Mars. Mars is the fourth planet in the solar. Mars is the fourth planet in the solar system. It is also called the red planet because the soil, the rocks over there is red in color. Even the sky also appears red due to the presence of dust in it. So it is called the red planet. Everything appears red over there. And it is also named after the Roman god of war. Scientists believe that it is the only planet after Earth where life can be possible, but still not found yet that life is there. Coming to the fifth planet, that is the Jupiter. It is the very big planet in the whole solar system. Also, more than 1,000 of Earth can go inside Jupiter if the Jupiter were hollow from inside. Jupiter has around 28 satellites. They have around 28 satellites, and Ganymede is one among them. Jupiter moves very fast, and when it moves very fast, it pulls the clouds forming the stripes around it. So it appears that Jupiter also has a ring, but they don't have a ring around them. Now coming to Saturn. Saturn is also called the ring planet, and it is very beautiful planet. Very beautiful planet with the seven rings, and they have their own satellite. It is the second largest planet after Jupiter. And now coming to the Uranus. Uranus is the seventh planet in the solar system, and it is named by the Romans after the god of sky. So it is a little larger than the Earth, as the four Earth can fit inside the planet Uranus. They have around 15 satellites. Now coming to the eighth planet, that is the Neptune, and named after the Roman god of sea. They have around 8 planets. It is the farthest planet. This is all about the planet, that is the eighth planet in the solar system. Now we are going to discuss about the asteroids and the comet. What are asteroids? So asteroids are nothing but the minor planets. They also revolve around the sun. So also known as minor planet because they revolve around the sun. They are made up of rocks and metals and they come in all the sizes. They generally are made up of rocks and metals. They revolve around the sun and mostly in between the belt between the Mars and the Jupiter. You might have seen a celestial body with the head and a tail that is coming attached to the head. This is nothing but the comet, and we can generally see a comet from the surface of the earth. Yes, so comets are the lump of ice and dust. They are made of generally from the ice and dust, and they periodically appear. After some years they appear and can be seen from the surface of the earth. They come into the center of the solar system from somewhere, from the outer space. They come to near to the surface of the earth, near the surface of the earth, and they can be seen from the earth also. Generally it happens in between 70 to 80 years. Some comets take repeated trips. So what happens, they take repeated trips, that is after 70 years they come near the surface of the earth and can be seen to and can be seen by us from the surface of the earth. When comets get close enough to the sun, heat makes them start to evaporate. And generally what happens, the tail, the head and the tail is there. This is the head and this is the tail. The head is called the nucleus and the tail is generally, and the long tails are formed due to the jets of gases. So jets of gases makes the tail and it can be seen from the earth, but they are not. So what happens when they come near the sun, the tails generally gets evaporated. They generally gets evaporated by the heat of the sun. So what's the definition? The comet is a celestial body made up of frozen rocks and gas that revolve in an orbit around the sun. They also revolve in an orbit around the sun. It has a bright head that is called the nucleus and a hazy tail, and which points away from the sun. So tail generally points away from the sun. So tail generally consists of the evaporated gas and they are heated by the rays of the sun. So the tail can be millions of millions kilometer long. The tail is million or million kilometer long. So today we studied about the planet and the earth, which is a home planet. It takes around 365 one-fourth day to complete one revolution around the sun. All the planet revolve around the sun, and our earth takes 365 one-fourth day to revolve around the sun, and it takes around 24 hours to revolve around, to rotate around its own axis. And the earth is around 150 million kilometers away from the sun. So this is all about the solar system, and we talked about the planets in the solar system, that is the 8 planet. We spoke about the comets and the asteroids, and we also spoke about the galaxies and the universe. Thank you.